Good afternoon to the participants of Gas Economy 2021 virtual conclave. My congratulations to Professor Iyer and his team for organizing this, and to all of you who have participated in this program. So I will now talk very briefly about a major initiative of Government of India for the area of compressed biogas. Our program called SATAT, where the target is to set up 5,000 compressed biogas plants all over the country and then use this biogas either to blend in the natural gas, which means that inject in the pipelines, or use directly in various forms, including by dispensing through retail outlets. So already some 12 plants have been commissioned, and this is being dispensed from around 20 retail outlets. In one case, the gas is also being injected into city gas distribution network. More than 2,100 LOIs have already been issued by various companies who are implementing this program, and there is tremendous interest. But there is huge challenge also, because setting up such large number of plants, and most of them located in rural areas and depending on and dependent on feed which is seasonal and sometimes difficult to collect, is a challenge. But this program has huge huge uses, lot of benefits, not only for the farmers if it is based on urban waste, then for residents of the urban area, but also in terms of environment, also in terms of import substitution, or as a promotion for Atmanirbhar Bharat, because we are substituting something which is imported. We are substituting fuel, fossil fuel, which is otherwise imported. So the model is that different types of feed, which could be agriculture feeds, right from parali, rice husk, it could be even cow dung, it could be food waste or all types of other waste available in the rural areas, or it could be urban waste, and urban waste could also be of all types and all forms. Now, this waste forms the feed. We could have multiple feed plants also, different types of feeds could get used. The size of plant can also vary. Typically, we are talking of, say, 10 to 20 ton per day production plant, which would use approximately, say, 100 or a little more than 100 tons of feed per day. And this would involve, say, investment of ranging from, say, 20, 30 crores to going up to 50, 60 or 70 crore rupees, and involve getting farmers who will benefit, and entrepreneurs who will set up the plant, and then the technology providers who have the technology, because different technologies are available all over the world. This becomes a boon for agriculture, if we are looking at organic farming, or if we are looking at farming which is chemical free, or if we are looking at recirculating the or a circular economy where we don't waste stuff and it gets recirculated back into the same system. So this way, then it becomes very much beneficial for the rural economy. I would say that this is a program which should be supported by all the stakeholders, because it generates economic activity right in rural areas. The compressed biogas which is produced can also be immediately used in the rural areas for running tractors. We've been talking to tractor manufacturers and requesting them to manufacture tractors which run on CNG, And CNG and CBG, it's same, it's methane. And therefore, they can also run on compressed biogas. And also for running of various other agriculture equipment on this fuel, which would also mean that the whole agriculture economy then benefits. The model also requires that we identify areas where these plants can come up so that there is no problem for feedstock in the long run, which would mean that a catchment area, if marked for one plant, only one plant should come up in that catchment area, and a continuous supply of feed should be there. So that state governments are working on that also. And transportation of feedstock, temporary storage of feedstock, these are some of the other challenges. Financing is a very crucial and critical area as on today, because while financial institutions are supporting, but then probably we need much more support, because these 2,100 LOIs which have been issued, all these plants now have to go for financial closure. Only around 80 have so far got financial closure. But right. I'm quite sure that in the next year or so, things would move very fast, and we will have very good examples coming up all over the country, which would then benefit and encourage others to come forward and give a little more pace to this. So my good wishes to all those who are participating in Satat program. This is like service to the nation, service to the society, besides being a good business venture. And I would also like to congratulate those who are being awarded today, those who are being recognized for their contribution to the sector. So my congratulations to Shri Sushil Chandra Tripathi, his family, who was formerly Secretary for Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Also, my congratulations to Dr. Goetz Bormarksen, Vice President, and Evonik Resource Efficiency, Germany. And again, my congratulations to Dr. Hirdesh K. Khanna, who is an independent consultant. And thank you to Dr. Iyer and his team for recognizing such people who have made very good contribution to this sector. So thank you very much.